What you're about to watch is a nightmare. It is not meant to be prophetic. It need not happen. It's the fervent and urgent prayer of all men of good will that it never shall happen. But in this place, in this moment, it does happen.
Hail to the king, baby.
Welcome everyone to Haven of Horror. I am Subject, and this stream is sponsored by Matt Sheepdog Peanut Butter Whiskey. Noah, I don't know if you're a drinker, but you should really try this. It's good.
I might. We're not actually sponsored, but
yeah. We're not sponsored, but I would accept a sponsorship. I would accept a sponsorship.
Reach out to us if you're interested.
Yeah, Noah, it's as always good to see you, buddy. We are doing Cut One of the Dead. I mean, One Cut of the Dead. I have seen this before. This was your first time.
Yeah.
And so I am going to let you do the description, since Description Man, I mean, the Canadian, is not here. So tell us a little more about, I guess, I don't know why I said more. We haven't said anything yet. Tell us about One Cut of the Dead.
One Cut of the Dead is a Japanese zombie movie. It's actually kind of a meta thing. It's about a film crew who is filming a zombie movie in some sort of abandoned building that's actually haunted. So real zombies end up coming and disturbing the project and killing off the crew. And about 30 minutes in, the whole thing changes, and it kind of recontextualizes everything you saw in the movie up until that point.
That is a good description. Okay, so I mentioned before we started this that I don't know what I think about this movie. I think the first 30 minutes, like you mentioned, where that kind of, right before kind of the complete shift, is awesome.
Yeah.
And then it loses me in that second half, personally.
See, that the second half is where it picked up for me. The first 30 minutes are interesting, but I was kind of honestly struggling to be like, all right, what's so special about this movie?
So let me ask you this, because I was thinking about that while watching this. You are a student of making films. Mm-hmm. Okay. And see, I am not. I am a zombie fan. Yeah. And you are too, I think, you know, from what little... So I wonder if I gravitated more towards the first half because it's just a zombie film. And you towards the second half because it's more about making a zombie film?
Yeah. Yeah, no, I think that's really what I latched onto. And I think what a lot of people who are also filmmakers like about the second half of the movie. And we should say, obviously, like, full spoilers up until this point. I mean, yeah, most of our reviews already have spoilers, but like this is a twist I don't want to spoil for people who haven't seen this movie, because up to the 30 minute point, this stops becoming a zombie movie and it becomes a movie about making a zombie movie, and a pretty good one at that, I think.
Yeah. So I struggle to call this movie bad by any means, but as someone who doesn't care about the filmmaking part of films, other than just like, I like to hear stories about the making of movies. So I guess maybe I'm sounding a little hypocritical here. I check out after that 30 minute mark. Yeah. I don't care about anything after that 30-minute mark.
Yeah, that's fair. Well, for me, watching it for the first time, like I said, I was liking it in the 30 minutes, the first 30 minutes, but I was really thinking, like, yeah, it's good, but, like, what is so special about this movie? Like, I hear people rave about it all the time. Or, you know, I've heard a lot of positive things about it. And I was kind of expecting there to be another twist, but I was not expecting the whole thing, everything we were watching up until that point, to just turn out to be basically, you know, a film within a film. And it's like, that's not the actual movie you're watching.
Yeah, so let me ask you this then, because I almost wonder as well as if I'm being unfair, because it's not really a zombie film. But how would you compare this to the other zombie movies that I know you've seen, like the Romero films? We watched Anna and the Apocalypse, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Those are definitely, I mean, they're better zombie films just because they're more, well, I don't know. It's, would you not call it a zombie film after a certain point? Because, like, no real zombies are in the movie. When you think about it,
that's the tricky part, because there, yeah, like you said, there's no real zombies, and even the part that's like a zombie film, there's not really zombies, but at the same time, like, it's presented as a zombie. So am I being too nitpicky? Am I drunk?
Know.
Probably.
That's a yes. No. I think I'd still categorize this as a zombie film, but it's a different take on the zombie genre. It's a lot more fresh than your typical kind of, you know, group of people holed up in a place. And that's all, you know, you run into that kind of stuff in the first part, but you get through all of that pretty quickly.
And you know what frustrates me most is that first 30 minutes is a zombie movie I would really like to see, where it's like a bunch of people making a zombie movie and then a zombie outbreak happens and they don't realize that it's like a zombie outbreak.
Yeah.
That'd be such a cool movie.
It's a good but premise.
It's not the point of this movie, so it's not really fleshed out.
Yeah, no, you could have done something cool with that, but I did like the direction that they ended up taking. Just because I wasn't able to predict it. But there's a lot of cool things that make more sense once you watch the rest of the movie and see what was happening. Like, you have that one zombie actor that's like, he's like shuffling around. The first zombie that you see that bites the sound, I think it's the sound guy or some other guy. And he's like spinning on people. And at first I was like, oh, that's kind of, they're making their zombies like spin on people. That's a little weird. And then you find out he's a drunk and he's got like a bad drinking problem. So he's just like naturally shuffling that way because he's so drunk.
So let me ask you this, because the thing I was, I think confused me most is because they're like showing, you know, how this and this happened from the first 30 minutes. There's that scene in the first 30 minutes where the guy, like, stumbles in without an arm. And, like, the actress freaks out. Was that staged? Or, like, did she know that it wasn't really a zombie? But...
No, I think that guy was supposed to get his arm bitten off in that scene.
There's okay, but then how would the actress not know that he wasn't really missing an arm? Like, I know that there's good makeup effects in Hollywood. Or... the Japanese version of Hollywood, but surely being up front, like next to them, you'd be able to tell he's not really missing.
Well, I thought it was the character she was playing didn't know it was a real or fake arm.
Well, that's what I mean, though, is like how much of the first 30 minutes are staged and how much are the actor, the director trying to get a genuine reaction out of the actors?
Well, it's weird because there's some moments you find out weren't planned and were like improvised. that whole bit where the makeup woman's trying to kill the main actress because they think she might be bitten. I don't really know what the deal with that was, but you know, that was one thing that turned out to not be part of the script. So yeah, there's certain things where it's like,
you think it's playing fast and loose with its own internal logic to convey this idea.
Yeah. Yeah, I can see that. I don't know. I haven't thought about it for a while.
You haven't thought about it? That's what we do here.
Yeah, I needed more. I only watched the movie today, so I probably need more time to think about that. That's true. But this is also your second viewing.
This is true. And it's interesting because I thought being inebriated would alter my perception of the film, but it did not. If anything, the second half really dragged for me. Maybe that's because I'm in a hurry because I've got like 600 things to do tonight. But or that I'm drunk, one of the two. But I really felt like the second half dragged for me. But that might go into the I'm not caring about the filmmaking aspect of this movie. It is kind of interesting, though, that maybe there's a little bit of satirical element with them wanting him to make a zombie, like, short, all in one take.
No, but yeah, I can see why, if you're not interested in that kind of filmmaking stuff, that part can drag for you. Just because, like, I'd found it really interesting, and I can, like, from what little experience I've had making, like, just, like, student films, I can kind of relate to, like, just things. A lot of things will just go wrong, and you can't expect it, everything to, you know, work out perfectly. Like, you have to make quick decisions and be on your toes, so I can kind of relate to that.
So as a filmmaker, let me ask you this. Would you be able, do you think it would make you, cause you more stress to have to do something like this where they want it all in one take and it's like live?
Oh yeah, no, I don't think I'd be able to make this movie. It'd be too much stress for me. I'd have to have a lot more experience before I feel comfortable doing something like this.
Fair. So how did you feel about all the performances in both the first part and the second?
I thought it was pretty good across the board. I think that they were trying to make it so, like, because you have that opening scene where, like, the main actress is, like, you know, she has that big emotional part where she has to fend off the other character. And the director's like, oh, no, you need to give me more. You're not giving enough. I don't think she was really that bad initially. Because, like, I thought, like, all around, the acting was pretty good.
I would agree with that. I kind of have the same thing with this as, I forget what movie it was. Maybe it was The Grudge. No, The Ring. Ringu.
The Ring. We reviewed Ringu.
Or another foreign film that we've talked about recently. I have a hard time with movies like this of telling 100% if, like, somebody's giving a good performance. Because it is harder to...
I don't know the language.
Yeah, I don't know the language, so I'm hoping that they you know, are doing a good job. For the most part, I thought everyone was good. I thought the director was really good.
Director.
Yeah. He's great. It kind of, that, and the director especially goes back to what I said, where I think there's some satire in this film. Because it really seems like he's willing to go to, like, insane lengths to get a good performance. Yeah. And, yeah, I mean, obviously, I don't know any directors in real life other than, like, the people I've had on here that make, like, student films or fan films, which, all the respect in the fucking world to fan films. Fan films are amazing. In fact, I would love to take a look at some fan films with you one day. since you're more of a filmmaker than I am, I've got a couple I want to show you. I'm rambling.
Yeah, no, but I think the director is...
I thought it was a cool idea.
Mm-hmm. Well, both the actual director in the movie that's making the movie and the character he's playing are really interesting, because the character he's playing is like you said, he goes to insane lengths. He endangers his crew and to make like a real realistic zombie movie.
Well, I don't really know this, but everyone watches Red Letter Media. All of your favorite YouTubers do. Not that we're anyone's favorite YouTubers. I'm not that self-absorbed. But he is a big fan of this film. And it's interesting because I think I can kind of see why now, having talked to you, because Jay is more of a filmmaker. And I think, you know, looks more at how, like, how a film is made. And this was written and directed by the same guy. I'm not going to pretend to say his name. I don't think I could say it sober, let alone drunk.
I can't pronounce anything in Japanese that well.
Well, Torgo, I'm going to be honest. That's most of what I had to say. Because the part that I do like, and I'm going to let you do your rest of your thoughts here in a second. I'm just saying that I think I've kind of reached the end of what I have to say about it personally. The stuff that I latched onto was the first 30 minutes. I wish somebody would make a film like that, like an actual movie like that. Because I think you could do some real social commentary, which is what zombies are best used for. Unless you're in the apocalypse, that movie's wonderful. Fuck you if you don't agree. But I wish that had been more of the film. The filmmaking stuff didn't really appeal to me personally, but I can see why it did. My final score for this review is going to be a 3.5. I can't call this movie a bad movie, but I will never watch this again. It's not made for me, personally.
Fair enough. Yeah, no, this is definitely a movie for people who are interested in filmmaking or just want to become a filmmaker, or who already are, if you already are a filmmaker. And just like how crazy working on a film can be, and like how much things can go wrong. I did enjoy the first 30 minutes. I didn't hate it or anything, but there's a lot of things, and even, you know, there's stuff in the second half that kind of points out like how cheesy some of the stuff in the first 30 minutes is. Like, you have that part, they even say, like, there's that cheesy camera movement where they're like zooming in back and forth to the zombie that's chasing the main actress. And like some of the shaky cam, I know it's supposed to be like a documentary style movie, but like some of that was like just really hard for me to look at on a surface level.
I'm so tired of shaky cam.
Yeah, all that shaky cam. Yeah, it's supposed to be like a kind of like a found footage zombie movie, which I get what they're going for, but you know, not really.
Best found footage zombie movie that I've seen.
Yeah, and I mean, this would probably be the only found footage zombie movie I've seen. I haven't seen.
We've seen two of them.
Yeah, I know.
I saw the Romero one.
Yeah. What is that? Diary of the Dead?
Diary of the Dead.
Okay.
It's not good.
Yeah, I might not watch it.
We'll review it one of these days. It'll come to Shudder.
Oh, no. But overall, I'm going to give it a 4 out of 5. I liked it a lot. I can see... I like the zombie genre, but it's kind of something that I think is played out at this point. And there's... Outside of Romero and Shaun of the Dead, and now this, it's not like my favorite subgenre of horror. It's probably one of my least favorite, to be honest, but this was a really fresh take on that subgenre. So
you forgot the best modern zombie movie, fuck.
What's that? And in the apocalypse. Oh yeah, you are the only yeah, it slipped my mind.
Now, zombies, I may have told you this, I don't remember. I wouldn't remember if I was sober, but zombies are my second favorite subgenre. Of course, my favorite is slashers, with zombies being in a second. My least favorite is paranormal, because it's all bullshit.
I like paranormal stuff.
I love The Exorcist. Everything after The Exorcist is bullshit. But no, I'm glad that you liked it more than me. I'm surprised there's only about half a star difference between us. I kind of expected it to be a bigger difference.
Well, the way you were talking about it, I was expecting you to rate it lower.
So I'm torn because I don't think this is a bad movie. I think this is actually a really good movie. I just don't like it.
Well, yeah, and I mean, that's fair. There's plenty of, you know, classic movies that I just can't get into.
Torgo going to confess some sins right here on Haven of Horror?
Right, well, now I'm blanking on one. It put me on the spot.
You brought it up, you fuck!
Well, a lot of them aren't even horror, so it's like not really worth bringing up.
If it's not horror, we don't care. This is a horror channel, you fuck.
Yeah.
No, I'm just kidding. Torgo, as always, it's been a pleasure. Are you ready for our favorite part of the night?
Let's spin the wheel.
The Wheel of the Worst. Oh, wait, that's...
That's a different show.
That's a different show. Okay. I'm going to spin the wheel.
I hope you remember this review.
Oh, shit. Deep Red. I don't even remember what that is.
I have no idea.
Do you want to check and make sure that it is still
on Shutter? I don't have my phone with me, but
okay. Yes, it is.
1975.
Oh, and this is another Argento movie.
Oh, cool.
He did that one movie we did, right? With the spiders?
Actually, did we do an Argento movie?
Or... No, we did Fulci.
Yeah, we did
Fulci. This is our first Argento movie.
We did Mario Bava and we did Lucio Fulci. So this is our first Argento. Nice.
He's one of those directors I've always really wanted to get into. I just never have had time.
Yeah, I don't think I've seen a single one of his movies, so...
God, dude. Okay, hold on. Yeah. Hold on. What is it? Deep Red. If I read this right, this has the best tagline. I just typed in Deep Red, and I'm just getting a bunch of different shades of red.
Deep Red 1975.
When was the last time you were really scared? Psycho? The Exorcist? Jaws? Now there's Deep Red.
Yeah, I mean, those are other movies that exist.
Those are definitely movies that exist. Well, Torgo, as always, it has been a pleasure. Thank you for dealing with me tonight. I drank a little bit more than I meant to before the review started. But as always, it has been a pleasure, and I will see you next week.
It's been great. Yeah.
For Deep Red. Have a great night, everybody.